Hi, this is Gabriela Ortiz for the Stata YouTube channel. I'd like to show you a new feature in Stata 16 for fitting random effects models with endogenous sample selection. To put this term in context, let's think about modeling income. We observe income only for individuals that work, but there are unobservable factors, such as ability, that affect income and work status. Endogenous sample selection refers to these cases where the unobserved factors that affect whether we observe the outcome are related to the unobserved factors that affect the outcome itself. In Stata 16, you can use xtheckman to fit random effects models with endogenous sample selection. This command incorporates within-panel correlations so that you can obtain both consistent and efficient estimates. After fitting a model with xtheckman, you can graph expected means and their confidence intervals, obtain predictions and selection probabilities, perform conditional analyses, and much more. To demonstrate how you can fit a model with xtheckman, I've loaded a fictional dataset with information on adults' wages, their age, and tenure on their most recent job. I've used xtset to declare the data to be panel data. We have repeated observations for individuals identified by the variable person ID, and the variable year identifies the times within panels. You can see that wages were recorded for the years 2013 to 2016. I want to model an individual's wage, or the wage they would have received, as a function of their age and tenure. However, I only have wage information for individuals that worked, and I suspect that the unobserved factors that influence somebody's wage are related to the unobserved factors that influence whether they work or not. So I'll use xtheckman to model an individual's choice to work as a function of their age and the job market conditions. To fit this model, I can go to Statistics and select Panel Data, Sample Selection Models, and Linear Regression with Sample Selection. Here I'll specify the dependent variable wage, and for the independent variables, I'll include age and age squared, as well as tenure. And to model whether somebody works or not, I'll include also age and age squared, as well as the market conditions. So now I can click OK to fit this model. So this is the command I could have typed, xtheckman. The select option is used to specify the selection model. In the header, I see the number of observations in which an individual was working and the number of observations in which they weren't. I also see that we had 600 individuals observed over 4 time periods. Now, the first 2 tables report the coefficients for the wage and working equations. And below that, I see estimates of the variance of the observation level error for wage and the correlation of these errors with the observation level errors for working. Next, I see estimates of the variances of the random effects for wage and working, as well as their correlation. We can conclude that we have endogenous sample selection if at least one of these correlations is significantly different from zero. Both correlations are positive and significantly different from zero. This implies that the unobserved factors that increase the chances of working also tend to increase wages. We can interpret the coefficients in the wage equation in the usual way, and we can use margins to help us further interpret the results. For instance, in this model, age has a positive coefficient, but age squared has a negative coefficient. I can use margins to interpret the effect of an individual's age on their wage. So I can go to Statistics and select Postestimation, Marginal Effects, and Basic and Low Dimensional Analysis. And here I want to compute the expected wage for different counterfactual levels of age. So let me specify age, and I'll set everybody's age to 30, 35, 40, and so on up until 70. So here I see the margins command that I could have typed. And I see an increase in expected wages from the 30s to the 60s, but it seems to level off once you're in your 60s. And I can visualize this with margins plot. So here you can see how it levels off. So this is how you can fit random effects models with endogenous sample selection in Stata. If you would like to learn more about the new xtheckman command in Stata 16, you can download the manual from our website at stata.com. Thank you for watching.